Good day to you. In this video, the topic will be on nutrition in humans. Nutrition is the process where organisms obtain energy and raw materials from food for growth, repair, and maintenance. And this is the basic anatomy of the human digestive system. You don't need to know everything, but you need to know the location of these names, their job, what do they do for you in the process of digestion. A very quick run through of the process from eating to ingestion, from ingestion to egestion. Starting from the mouth, you eat, you chew things, physical digestion takes place, pH is neutral, then after that you swallow, it goes to the stomach where it's acidic in nature for the acidic enzymes to work, then after that it passes through into the duodenum whereby bile from gallbladder, the pancreatic juice, intestinal juice starts to mix with the digested mixture, it becomes alkaline in pH for the alkaline enzymes to work, so it digests and absorbs all the way through the small intestine. Then it goes to the large intestine where mainly only water is absorbed and all the remainder of the undigested food materials will be passed out. Okay, so let's take a deeper look at the process of digestion, the process where large food molecules are broken down into small ones to be absorbed into the body. Why does this need to happen? You cannot take a piece of a serving of a burger and you just force it into yourself. You need to make it into liquid form so that the cells can absorb the materials from it and the body can make sense of what goes where. And anything that you eat, you have to make it into liquid form first, then the body can make use of. So first, ingestion. You put things into your mouth, you eat. There's physical digestion that occurs. The teeth, okay, breaks up the stuff, the tongues roll things around. And also the salivary amylase starts breaking down starch into maltose. Then after that you swallow, basically nothing happens. It just pass from the mouth to the stomach. And over here, where gastric juices starts to be secreted, it's acid in nature, so it activates this protein called pepsin. Pepsin starts breaking down some proteins, as you can see in the following word equation. And then after that, it goes into the small intestine where a lot of things are happening. The pancreas produce these, the gallbladder produce this, and the small intestine produce these. Okay, so all three fluids are alkaline. They neutralize the acidic material that comes from the stomach and produce an alkaline medium for these intestinal enzymes to work. Next, for the digestion of the materials that come through the small intestine, meeting with all these enzymes, it's quite straightforward to match what material is broken down by what enzyme. So amylase is breaking down starch to maltose, then trypsin breaks down proteins, lipase breaks down lipids, peptidase breaks down polypeptides to amino acid, maltase breaks down maltose to glucose. So perhaps the vocabulary over here that's a little bit difficult would be trypsin, pepsin, bile, that doesn't match its substrate. And for bile, they don't really chemically digest the fat, it's more of emulsification. So they break down the larger fat droplets into smaller ones to increase the surface area to speed up the process of digestion of fats. So there's more area for the lipase to work on. And this is a pretty good table that summarizes what happens where, by what, does what. I will usually get my students to be able to recall all of this. Next, we go on to absorption, the process where digested food material is absorbed into body cell. So the absorption process starts actually in the small intestine. It's designed, in biology we call it adaptation, so that it helps it do its job well. The adaptation, the design is, it has a lot of infoldings, finger-like projection called the villi, and on these villi or singular villus, they have microvilli as well. So this increases the surface area a lot for the absorption into the bloodstream or the lymphatic capillary, and it's brought around your whole body for use. Glucose and amino acids, as well as fatty acid and glycerol, they are all brought into the body mainly by diffusion. Glucose and amino acids are also absorbed by active transport. For the glycerol and fatty acids, they enter the lymphatic capillary. And finally, the undigested food material will be stored temporarily in the large intestine, the rectum, and get passed out through the anus. And in the large intestine, mainly only water is absorbed. So from this small intestine, the materials are absorbed, and they travel through this very special expressway to the liver from the small intestine. It's called the hepatic portal vein. And finally, you will need to understand the functions of the liver. Liver is a very important organ in this chapter. There's a lot of questions being designed around this topic. Okay, number one, it regulates the glucose concentration in the blood. So if it's too high, then insulin will be produced by the pancreas to tell liver to convert glucose into glycogen. Or when there is too little glucose in the blood, the pancreas will produce glucagon to tell the liver to convert glycogen into glucose, thereby maintaining constant internal environment for the glucose concentration. That is called homeostasis. Don't worry too much about this word homeostasis. This is just mainly for exposure. So that is for glucose concentration. Number two, breakdown of amino acids into urea. For excess amino acids that has been absorbed by the digestion process, it goes to the liver. And those that are not needed, they will be deaminated. What this means is in the amino acid, like mentioned in the previous nutrition video, the amine group of the molecule has to be removed so that the resulting component is more easily converted to usable products. The amine group is removed and converted into urea that's passed out in the urine. The next idea will be the breakdown of alcohol. The liver contains this enzyme called alcohol dehydrogenase, breaking down alcohol into acetaldehyde, where this acetaldehyde can be further broken down to provide energy for a variety of activities. In this chapter, Nutrition in Humans, there is some topics that the pure science student will need to take note of. Number one will be peristalsis. Peristalsis is the rhythmic wave-like motion of the tube, be it esophagus or the intestine, large intestine, small intestine. They work by having antagonistic muscles. They work in opposite coordination. So you don't have to remember actually what happens, what at when. You just have to imagine yourself squeezing toothpaste. And I believe you brush your teeth, so you know how to squeeze toothpaste. The main mass, you have to put your finger behind the main mass and squeeze it, right? So there's a contraction behind the foot mass. That's the function of the circular muscle. The circular muscle contracts behind the foot mass. And because it's antagonistic, the longitudinal muscle will be relaxed. And then you just flip the combination when the foot mass is in line with the muscle itself. There are four boxes here. You only need to remember one. The rest is just flip and rotate. So don't have to worry too much about this. PR science students also need to understand the design of the villus. So it's a finger-like projection and it's equipped with a lacteal. A lacteal is a blood vessel for the lymphatic capillary. Lymphatic capillary is like the sibling of a blood vessel. So a blood vessel, you can imagine that it's like the road that carries cars. The lymphatic vessel is like a pedestrian footpath where it carries people. It still brings people and materials from one point to another, just that one is a road and one is a footpath. It's similar, but the things that they carry is different, though they all carry materials from one place to another. Different things will go to different modes of transportation. So they will use the different route, either the road or the footpath, the blood capillary or the lacteal. In each finger-like projection, the epithelial cells are also armed with microvilli. It's all just for adaptation and design to better absorb materials. So glucose amino acids enter the blood capillaries, the fatty acid and glycerol enter the lacteal. And all of this, they go to the liver. The liver will sort and handle everything. Fats being absorbed, the liver will deal with it. The fat will command it to build cells, membranes, broken down for energy, or to be stored in fat cells or adipose tissue. They help to keep the organism warm or act as shock absorber. And of course, too much or too little has its consequences. You also need to know the breakdown of red blood cells. Actually, red blood cells are broken down in the spleen, not really in the liver. But the hemoglobin, the oxygen carrier, is actually broken down in the liver. The iron component is stored and the rest of the material, the proteins, okay, is used to create bile for digestion. So very efficient. Huh? Last topic of the video will be the effects of alcohol consumption, including these, and the social implications are these. And so of course I won't go too much into detail of this alcohol consumption part. So all in all, the design of biology education is to help students make well-informed choices of your life activities. Okay, and that is all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a like and subscribe. Share it with somebody that needs to see this. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.